What's up, everybody?
Hey, everybody.
It's John and Ellie with Crippled Fox Gaming, and we aren't... Don't talk to strangers! Is the other Stephen Rhodes game that I got in this Kickstarter thing that's now available for you to get. And we're going to play through this clumsily, because we've done it once, and we're going to kind of...
I personally talking to strangers.
You know, everyone's a stranger, just a friend you haven't met.
True that.
There you go. I'm throwing my terrible idioms
in. Even if it's an alien.
This is a little tiny game. All the games come in these little tiny boxes. They're just a nice little compact size. This has got two different sides. This is side A. They say to do side A before you get all complex and go to side B. And we haven't played side B because side A is still really hard for me to figure out and win.
We only played this once. Yeah. We played it with a group.
And it comes with your stranger tokens, and you get to try to get all your little kids or your little kid chits home from school. I'm just gonna sit down and read the fluff for this overview. Yeah, that's a great start.
Great start.
Yeah. Mom and Dad are too busy serving the plutocracy to notice, but there are strangers popping up everywhere, and these strangers are really strange. School just let out, and you aren't trying to get abducted by strange aliens. You and your friends need to get somewhere safe and fun before the strangers infest the entire neighborhood. Each turn, you'll play a move card from your hand to help your kid travel from the starting school space to any scoring location. Walk, run, or even take the school bus or city bus to score a great spot. And the fewer turns it takes you, the better. Some scoring locations will be worth a lot of points, while others may be focused around a permanent bonus they provide each time you score there. Once the kid you're moving scores, you get to place a new kid who will seek out other scoring spaces. Draw a new move card as you pass the turn to the next player, but watch out! The moment anyone draws a stranger or a saucer card, they'll have to play it immediately, and if a stranger enters your space, you'll be abducted. And when all strangers have been placed, this game is over. Most points scored from kids by the end of the game wins! Okay, we have shuffled up the move deck.
Card, you're gonna show them that.
This is the stranger. I wonder if I should kick on another... Because that's super, super bright. There we go. This is the stranger. Stranger sighting. When you draw this, immediately place a stranger. You're going to place them on these little stranger locations on the board. I'm going to pause this and see if I can get a different camera up. There. You know, we've been messing around with this all day and are still trying to get back on this bike to do stuff. Don't touch strangers. Let's see if this one works. That's better. There. Now.
Now who says you don't know what you're doing?
Thank you so much. Yeah.
Now who's
still only mildly competent in whatever it is he's doing. We've shuffled the move deck. We split it into two piles to be easier for everyone to reach. Each player selects a color. I selected yellow. Ellie selected purple. Decide whether you want to play board A or board B. We're playing board A because it's easier. Set aside the 10 stranger tokens. Did that. Each player draws a hand of three cards. Any stranger or saucer cards immediately drawn this time are discarded immediately with no effect. And replaced with a new drawn card. Draw your cards, ma'am. I will draw mine when you are done. And we will just plop those cards over here.
All right, I did not get any.
No stranger dangers. Nope. No this, none of that, and none of these. And all the artwork, again, is this really super fun with Dick and Jane kind of stuff. And you look at the camera, did you? You're looking at my cards?
Ooh, I didn't.
Oh, all right. Great. That's perfect.
Sorry.
There's a dog roaming around who likes to have attention paid to him.
Oh, it's okay.
So we're going to go with the last person who... you determine who... the person who was most recently inside of school goes first.
That would be you.
It's me. I am going to go. Winning and losing the game. When the last stranger is placed on the board in one of their spots... 8 for board A and 10 for board B. The game ends immediately. The game also ends if one player scores all of their kids, but this is unlikely because you've got 3, 6, 9, 12, 13. Not with me. I'm here to go, hooray! Yeah, things are fun.
All right, I'm going to move three spaces.
Okay.
And I'm going to go with, floop right
young
up
young Bobby on his skateboard. Three spaces.
And I can add a bonus to...
You get a plus one to your hand size.
I guess I can go up here.
So yeah.
So you can get in too.
Thanks.
So I can get... Uh-oh.
You're getting... Oh, crud. What happened? Already? Oh, man. Stranger sighting. Already. Oh, it's not great. I got to get a little chroma key on this and so it can magically appear. I found out how to do that. Okay. So you put him over... You didn't want to abduct little Sally? That's awfully nice of you. Because she could have dropped one right here. Okay, you draw... No, this is your draw. You're drawing this.
Yeah, I drew a stranger.
If you're not playing it. Oh, wait. You draw him, you got to throw him out. Oh, my
God. I got
well, this
I got
game's going to be over record time. Not second... second. Well, thanks,
here.
Jerk. Okay. Sally, no!
So I'm going to draw one. Okay, finally got up to my size.
All right.
So is it really all you can do on your thing is just put someone down?
You can move, yeah, you put a guy, you put a kid down because there's 13 of them. And there's plenty of them. And normally, again, this is a, 2 to 5 player, is that what it says on the back? I would assume, 2 to 5?
Yeah.
Because...
No, 4. Because there's only 4 kinds of...
Oh, there's 4 colors, okay. Yeah, well, there's 2 to 4. I guess I could just flip it around and read the back. There's a, if you hear some sort of weird noise, there's a corgi in our midst who tends to like to vocalize when we're doing stuff.
Okay, all I can do is put one on the floor. Okay. So, your turn.
Well, all I can do, that's all I could have done, because you kidnapped her on that turn, right? So I jump the gun, I'm putting Tammy on the board, and that's all I can do. And I've got no cards to play, I mean I could, but I could do that. Next. And I'll tell you why that's going on.
I guess I'm going to play a run card.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got
Stackless
2 spaces, so I'm going to go there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm going to go with...
And one thing we didn't say. If these are on the board, you can't pass these unless you're using transportation.
Yeah.
So, this is blocked now, but if you were, because you can move in between buses, you get cards that allow you to move in between, like if you were on a school bus, and you can move to another school bus,
mm-hmm.
and you can go through those, but or if you're on, say I took 2 spaces, I land on a city bus, and I have, then my next turn, I have one that says move between any 2 city buses, I
can
go all
that way. That's how we're playing it. I believe that is how this is played, because
Dynamite Games, let us know.
Stephen Rhodes, talking to you. Cryptozoic, shout out. And anybody else who knows how to play this. Leave, comments and questions advice.
Only the second time we played it, and we played it kind of late into the night.
And there may or may not have been some
sort of...
Few drinks
in. Might have been a few drinks in.
Yeah, but there's also certain cards in here that you just go, wait a minute, where did this come from?
Yeah, what? Okay.
There is an unboxing video. I can't remember who did it, but I'll try to post a link in the comments and stuff like that. Did you go? So you went?
Yep,
okay.
Yep.
I am going to go, Tammy, going to take the school bus. Boom. Move between. School bus stops.
School bus is
the
right.
School
this is a, yeah.
counts as a school bus stop. I'm going to have her go to here. She's heading home to the south end. 3 points if Sally gets there. Okay, I got to draw a card. A ding. Okay. Like this. Okay. Go ahead. I'm going to go through. There's other things. Move cards let you move any number of spaces. The number of spaces indicated on the thing. Moving any number of your kids. There's certain spots where if you get to the South Park, the North Park, you can add another kid to move. So you can add another one onto the start. I believe that's how this works.
Yeah, you can have 2 kids playing at the same time.
Or more if you've got more kids and if you've got more people meeting your other kids at the park.
Okay, I've got a run card, so I'm gonna move mm-hmm. 2 spaces. I'm gonna go right here.
Just 2? Okay.
Yeah.
You want to go back up to the library so you can fill your hand with more cards, like a
I'm
villain.
Try to get on here so I can get another card.
Into the kid. Okay.
Fudge.
Are you really dropping more? Oh, no. Well, again, this you can abduct your own guy. Hey, why'd you cover up the 7-point mansion spot?
You know, I could have been mean, but I was being mean.
Well, yeah, okay. So I'm going to go with... Oh, yeah. You got to replace it. You got to total it.
Oh.
Because you can have four in your hand.
The stranger pod. Flip the saucer coin.
Okay.
If you flip a saucer, replace any opposing unscored kid with one from your reserves.
Lame.
This may allow you to temporarily exceed your max kids.
Okay.
So
Okay, so here's the card. Strange pod card.
Oh, you're safe.
Good. And here's the coin that we flip. One side a saucer. The side... Little Larry hiding behind the mailbox. Good job, Larry. Thanks for peeking your head out. Okay, I have got a hop the fence card. Move one space, and you may go through a wall. Normally, you have to go through these doors here. I'm going to move a fence. I don't need to go through a wall. I got home.
Well, why wouldn't you just use one of your...
You just move one space.
Okay.
Because normally you have to go, like, if you wanted to get into the pool, I could hop from this bus stop into the pool, because you're hopping. Anywhere there's not an opening is a wall, is what we're saying. So you could hop, oh, I'm on the street, I'm going to hop the fence and go into the pool.
Gotcha.
Oh, I got to draw a card. Okay. Go ahead.
I'm going to move one space and go into here.
All right, so I am going to go with, on my turn, oh wait, I gotta wait for you. Are you really plopping down these visitors, madam? You are just, okay, these villains, you know, we should have played it on the other side, because the way you're pulling strangers, you're
gonna get, it's like...
I wonder if there's, I can't remember if there was, there's a way to, if you're playing two players, hey, maybe dump some of those people.
That's what I was wondering.
You know what? Everybody, as you're playing this, as you rush right out and buy it from our recommendations, because I really do fun, silly little games like this. Okay, you went. I put down, Marion is now in the school. It is your turn. I got no cards. I mean, I can't play a card.
I'm going to put little Jill right next to you.
All right.
Is that, do you think it's Jill?
All right, Marion, get to moving. What's going on? Let's go with the... gosh, I don't have nothing. I'm going to have Mary move one. I'm just going to walk. Walk one space. And then out we go. She walked over there, drawn a card. Hey, I like that card better. Ba-ba-ba-boom. That's what we drew. So here's our hand. We've got this one. We've got this one. Go ahead. And the one I just drew.
I only got one card, I got one right there. I can move between... I've got a card that says I can move between two city bus stops. And,
City bus stops?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not sure if... Oh, you're on the bus.
Yeah, Because
school buses, the school council school bus stop.
But I moved one, so that would be my move.
To get
and then,
to there?
Yeah.
Okay,
and
so then you're on the bus.
Yeah.
No stack limit on movement spaces. There are no limits to the number of kids that can be in a single movement space. But if the deck runs out, it's typically quite difficult for the deck to run out.
Aha! Look at what I got. All
right.
Heroic Dog. When you play this card, leave it face up in front of you for the rest of the game. Your kids may move through strangers, but... can still be abducted if a stranger lands on them.
Wow, neato! Someone likes them dogs. People, I like them. I like me a heroic dog. I don't know if a corgi could be considered heroic, but it'd be...
So if I lay this card down in front of me, does that count in my hand?
You just keep it. No, because it is not in your hand. It is in play, I would say.
Okay. So, all right.
Aces. All right, then. Well, we're going to do this. So where's she going? She's going to go... she's going to run... That. Oh, you villain. I'm gonna go. That was only a move. Oh, here we go. One. I'm playing the move two spaces card. And we're gonna go one, a tahoo into the pool.
Into the pool.
Good job, Marion.
Good job.
And I'll throw somebody out. Oh, hang on, we got a draw card. Okay.
I'm going to have to go through
these cards and see just exactly what all's in them. Yeah.
I've got a move between two school bus cards.
City buses. Okay.
And I'm going to move up to here.
Nice. Well, you're just all over the place. Any more aliens you're going to chuck out? I'm sorry, strangers. Okay. I'm going to drop down. Thomas is going to head out. I think. The cheaters, because I can't see tiny little faces on these cards. Oh, yeah, Thomas.
All right.
He's rocking the old style.
Did you draw your card? I did.
Yep.
I'm going to move one space up into here.
So we're good to go. Oh, you're up at home. Well, I need to get that.
Oh.
This is the one.
Saucer, when you draw this, immediately choose any kid, scored or unscored. Flip the saucer core to see if they're abducted.
Seriously?
Lame. Choose any kid.
Scored or unscored?
Scored or unscored. So I can take off.
So who are you picking? I've got a 3 point there. I've got a 2 point here.
I'll choose her.
That's not great. Come on. Oh. Hey, lady. Don't be flipping that cardboard coin on the floor.
You're abducted.
No, Tammy, no! That was a good music sting.
There you go. I was like, dun, dun, dun. All right.
All right, then. Well, I guess Thomas is going to go with... We're going to go... There is a place down here. It is the Pep Rally. If you get 1 to 4 kids, they're worth 0 points. If you have 5 to 9 kids, they're worth 1 point apiece. And if you get all 10 kids filling up this Pep Rally... 2 points apiece. Ba-ba-ba-boom.
And it could be anybody's. We looked that
up. Yeah, totally, yes.
Yeah, we were questioning that. It can be any like
multiple colors of kid tokens. So we're going with, we're just going to hop the fence again. We're going to move one. Get that, and there we go. And we're hopping the fence. But I don't need to hop the fence because it just lets me move one. So I'm going to go to here. Get going, Thomas. You got to go.
Hold on a second. Hang on a second, put little Sally on there.
Okay, we got this. Okay.
Your turn again. All I can do is put a little Sally on there.
Oakley doakley. I'm going to go with... I can't do that. I need to get... I should have done that. Between any of this one. We're going to go with... we're just going to hop the fence again. Over to one. We're going to go over here. We're heading everybody to the pool. Everybody in the pool. Everybody in the pool. Okay. So I got one of these. And I got one of the... I think I showed this already. We're good to go. And this one, not that great. Oh! Darn. Nothing. Okay. Here's the thing. Oh! No. I see. I was worried that something had happened and it had, would have kind of froze me up. But it did not.
I'm going to use this with this rad bike, and I get to move three.
That is so cool.
And I'm
going to show off the rad bike, bro.
And I can move through strangers anyway, but I used that because I needed 3 spaces to move.
So you can tell he's rad because he has a little cool headband.
He's rad.
A bandana. He's got a rad bike, too. Headband matches the bike. Are you serious?
Yes.
Are you... No, don't you... No. 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 No, Thomas! No!
Sorry, Thomas.
Just the worst. Okay. Well, I guess I'm going to throw Cousin Oliver? Sure. Haha, if you're over 40, everybody knows that joke. Huh? Is that your turn? You just abducted?
Well,
Cousin Oliver is going to go. Yeah, you dropped the card. You drew the card, and then the guy did the thing.
It's
a little
bit there. Okay.
Yeah. You're all on the north side. You're north side people. You're such snobs. Okay, my turn. Putting this down. Your turn.
Okay, putting this down. Your turn.
Okay, I'm going to go with... we're going to go with... moving Cousin Oliver over to here. From the bus stop. Move between the two school bus stops, including the one at the school. Boom. Hang on, I got to drop this. Okay. Strangers and saucers, place a stranger. Saucer cards, I was reading that.
Okay, I'm going to move it right there, and that's all I'm going to do.
Did you? Are you kidding me?
No.
Okay, we need to shuffle these better for demos.
I shuffle too. You shuffle and I shuffle.
There's your problem. Too many shufflings spoil the stack.
Is that it?
Yeah. Okay. I made up my own idiom.
With all right, emphasis your on turn. Kitty.
Okay, I'm going to go with...
Well, you have to put a kid on, don't you?
No, I got a kid.
Oh,
there.
You've got a kid on.
I'm going to go with the walkie-talkie. Move any number of kids one space. Well, I have one. That's the number. He's going to move into the South Park, where I get plus one kid to move. Let me check this real quick. The park. In addition to the indicated points value, each kid you have scored in the park, your max allowance of unscored kids in play is increased by one beyond the standard one. So I think what this means... Okay, I'm going to put young Barry Gibb. He's going to go in here. That's my one guy. And then I could throw another one down on my next turn, or I could move him, but I still need to draw a card.
Or you can move
The game is over because all the strangers are out.
Oh, no, there's one more.
Yeah.
No,
I see. Right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's cut off the pep rally. Okay.
So here's the thing, though. So you could put one down and move him, and then you could put another one down.
Another
and
one
move
down
him.
And move
him.
I believe so. Yeah. Because there's that one, the walkie talkies let the. Okay.
So you can move. So, okay.
What's this? I don't. Okay. Darn it.
That's all I can do.
That's all you're doing? Okay, I'm going to go with. Boom, 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 boom. I'm going to go with the school bus again, and we're going to dump young Barry Gibb. He's going to head over here to the other park. And I am going to be able to put a second kid, because I have plus one kids already. He doesn't need to move, so I'm going to do this. Dog! Okay. Saucer! When you draw this, immediately choose any kid, score or unscored. Flip the saucer coin to see if they're abducted, and draw a new card.
Damn.
Oh,
you.
I'm going to go with this little five-pointer here. Voop!
He's safe.
Well done. What did I say his name was? Larry.
Little Larry.
Sure.
Little Larry.
We'll go with, yeah. Okay. Not bad. Okay. There's a kid.
Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I still have a kid on the board, so take
it
off.
Hey, okay, I'll let you mulligan that then.
Yeah, okay. So, I'll just move on this turn.
Okay. It's not like we're betting thumbs. Yeah. So. Although, if I get some more kids in that park...
Well, I guess all I got is move one, so...
Okay. Don't draw it. Don't do it.
Okay. Uh-oh. Stray asteroids.
No!
Place this card on top of the board covering the area of 2x3 spaces. Everything in those spaces is now removed. This may result in kids being... Of kids being unscored, the number of strangers needed to fill the board being reduced, etc.
You are a monster. Because why wouldn't you score it right there? Because of course.
So this means this
clever.
Whole thing is off play.
Yeah, and now you just wiped out young Barry Gibb and cousin Oliver. Stray asteroid. Boom, right there. There you go. That's how monsters play this game. I'm talking about you.
I'm
talking about you.
Are you saying I'm a
monster? Because now I have no kids on the board, so I gotta go with. My turn. Did you draw your card, you villainess?
Yes, I did.
Okay. I'm going to put young, I don't know, Karen. Little Karen.
Little Karen.
Is hanging out in the thing.
I'm going to put little Charlie down.
All right. Well, we're going to go with, that's not a thing. If you're hearing a sound, there's a bulldog snoring under the table. So we're going to go with a run. And it's move two spaces. Off you go. I gotta get some more points on this board because you've just rooked me out of six and extra kids. You ding dang human being lady person.
I've got.
Okay, now I need to check something. Go ahead.
Mom's car. Move one of your kids into any home. Must be currently unoccupied, so I'm gonna move him right up here.
Into any home?
Yep.
In a car?
Mom's car.
Why would you not move into the 7-point car?
Because it's a mansion.
Oh, it's a mansion. My mistake. Okay, I gotcha.
So I just got him into the 5-pointer.
There you go. Cool. I'm going to go with total solo architect challenge. I don't need that. Runaway rule, optional rule, once the deck runs out. I got to do the general FAQ. Rad bike. Oh, here we go. The individual card clarity sort of pops. There's mom's card. Prom date. Can I move a scored kid? Okay. I've got the thing I'm going to do with Karen.
I screwed up again. I'll take him out and move her because I keep forgetting she's on the board. So I just moved him instead. So that's less kids.
Oh, okay, that's right, because you had a spare.
Yeah, I keep forgetting.
Well, the purple is kind of a little hard to see, but I'm going to...
Yeah, So sorry about that, guys. I
so I'm going to go with City Bus. We're going to go honk honk. Go to that City Bus so I can at least get to a home, at least get some points on the board. City Bus says to go, 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 bus pass. Okay, go ahead.
I'm going to put little Charlie down now.
There you go. Okay, I'm going to... Oh, and the other thing is, I believe you do not have to move the full movement, and you can't backtrack. You can't go one, two, three, and then do. Because there was a thing about that in here that we were reading. We've got a... is there a limit how you can occupy a pace? Full spaces. Do I have to move the full spaces? Okay, when you enter a scoring space, movement always stops. Well, I'm going to place my skateboard, and we're going to go right into that house. A kaboom. 3 points at least.
Oh, you can move more. You move 3 spaces.
You can move up to.
Oh,
because okay. Well, because that's the other thing I was just reading. Can I move or do I have to move the full amount of spaces on my move card? When you enter a scoring space, movement always stops, and you don't have to land exactly to score. However, otherwise, you must move the full. Oh, I say I corrected. You must move the full amount and can't backtrack to spaces already. So I didn't have to because I was able to score.
Okay.
So okay, gotcha. And so I have a full one of these and one of these. Gotcha.
Okay,
I need to throw somebody else on that board.
I'm going to move down two, and that's all I'm going to do.
I'm going to throw...
And...
Yeah! Boo!
All the strangers are out.
They're everywhere. They've taken over the town. So, you get to score yourself up.
Five,
yeah, you got your...
10,
dang it.
15, 16, 17.
I believe you win.
Yeah.
Because I got three... I got 5 points. But you know, I win in my heart.
In my heart?
In my heart, I won.
This game, I really...
Okay, here's my favorite card in the whole thing. Science Club Saviors. For each kid you have in the library, flip the saucer coin. If you hit at least 2 saucers, you win immediately.
Oh, there
you
go.
That's kind of rad. But someone blocked off the thing, and I guess I could have gone there to there.
Yeah.
But then you'd still have to flip. Okay, there's one. Crumbs. No, okay, it's on the floor. It didn't come up. Okay. Alright. But that is, that's the quickest way we know how to play, Don't Talk to Strangers. I like it a lot. It's very,
cool.
Very...
Yeah, it's very cool.
Let's dig through some of these other fun. Prom date. You may move any kid to the prom or pep rally. Okay. Pool party. If you have at least 2 kids at the same pool... You may move any 1 or 2 kids into that pool if there is room. Neat. Strangers, lots of movement cards, lots of saucer cards. So there's a lot of strangers in this deck. There's some fun cards. There's pretty much, Dyno Cab Service, like the Dyno Mite Games, who publishes this game. Pick one of your kids and choose 3 unscored spaces and 3 unscored. Pick one of your kids, words are hard. And choose 3 unscored spaces. The other players confer and select 1 of those spaces to move your kid to. Oh, okay.
I used that card last night.
Yeah, and I think it didn't go well for me here. I'm sure you have to. Hitchhiking. Move 1 of your kids to the library or a park. Neat. I like it. I like this game a lot. It's a very It's a nice, quick game. It's easy. You know, what do they say? 12 and up. I bet if your kid can read, there's nothing really untoward or unseemly about this game.
Yeah, it's not.
That you can, there's no, potential.
It's pretty funny, actually. It's other than, children getting abducted.
This Stray Asteroid is a BS card, if I've ever seen it, because it's real. Well, especially if you have more players. you've got, Oh, there's Men in Black card that I didn't. Up. So that's pretty much it. That is Don't Talk to Strangers. And when you do, don't talk to strangers.
If you're talking to me, you can talk to me. I'm an open.
You're strange, not a stranger.
Let's see if we can
strange,
find
stranger, strangest. Yeah, I want to see what that does. The new stepdad's pretty great.
You can
move to any house. That's how somebody got into the mansion.
Black. Here. Remove any stranger from the board to be placed again later, then take another turn.
Neato torpedo.
That's a cool thing.
That's your, nice. I like it.
New stepdad.
Yep, new stepdad. Any kid, move any kid from a Homer mansion into another Homer mansion. Nice.
Yeah, so.
Mom in her denim vest. I like it.
These Stephen Rhodes games, very fun.
Yeah,
we've
very
got
nice.
One more.
It's Let's Summon Demons. We'll be back once we figure out how to play that, because we haven't played it yet.
Yeah, we haven't played that one yet, but we're looking forward to it.
Yeah.
And as again, thank you, Dyno Mite Games, and for
thank
doing
you,
this.
Cryptozoic. I love it.
Super fun. I think this is one we probably will pull out again at our Halloween party.
Yes, yeah.
We might have multiple games going with multiple guests.
I'd wager.
That's kind of what we planned, is we could throw four people over here
and they're nothing that's really too heavy that's going to be, you know, oh, where's that one thing? Let me do that one thing that I won that one time on page 175. Oh, they ratted that out. No, these are just, you know.
Yeah, it's strictly
these are
fun
camping games. And what's that? Oh, yeah. That's the other.
This is definitely a good part. I mean, that's what I say is, like, I think we'll set up tables with these games for our guests because they're so fun and easy to learn, and we recommend it. They come in a box of three. The artwork, obviously, with Stephen
Rhodes. I'm not sure if this, I think, because they have it on their website. I have the Cryptozoic games. I'll put that in the notes on the game. You can get all three of them. They're really fun. They come in this really cool,
bookshelf
composite box. So yeah, bookshelf box. So, thank you. Words are bad for me in my mouth.
We're very impressed. So
yes,
good job,
like
Dyno Mite.
Thanks.
Good job.
We love it.
Stephen Rhodes. They're great.
We like you. Thanks for stopping. And make sure to hit this like and subscribes, and we'll
come see our pretty faces again.
Stuff.
Keep it spooky.
Keep it spooky. I like that a lot.
Later, guys.
Bye.